So finally, I want to talk a little bit how this module is organized. So we have every week a 1 hour lecture that delivers the concepts and gives you an overview. This is highly packed. Then we have about four lectures about distributed computing, four lectures about parallel computing, and typically we have about one invited talk. So we have a 1 hour practical a week, which is timetabled, but it's optional for you. So it follows the schedule that we have in the lecture. And we have two parts of it. So basically, students have to present the solutions or questions to exercise tasks. And part two is we discuss the new exercises that we have, such that everyone is able to perform these exercises. So the term exercises have been revised. So basically, every week we prescribe a 3 hour. We give you a worksheet with a 3 hour exercise that you can do. It's for your self-study to practice the lecture content. You can actually team up with colleagues, which is really welcome. And we have different tasks on each sheet that come with an estimated time that you should spend on it. And it may contain introductory and harder tasks. And you should really look into those tasks and do some of them in order to take benefit of the practical, right? We also advise that you store your work in a Git repository, which is basically a portfolio of this course, such that you can later look what you have done and how you developed. So we also include some group work, so some parts of the practical, and sometimes we actually give a little bit of tutorial as well, maybe used for the group work, for discussions, and this blends pretty much into the assessment. So the module is 100% exam. However, the exercises and group work that we do and formatively assess prepares you very well for the exam, I would say, right? So it's a good idea to do these tasks to prepare for the exam. So you can give always feedback to the lecturer during the practicals and so on. And we provide some quizzes that you can use for your self-study in Blackboard. So if we talk about group work, how does group work work? Well, we discuss or criticize exercises with your peers. Typically, you can group up with 2 to 4 people. Sometimes we have exercises where you brainstorm and design and solve small tasks, also groups 2 to 4. And again, I would store this in your Git portfolio. So the learning strategy of this module is prescribed next. Basically, it answers to you how you can achieve good marks. Okay? It's very important that you understand the learning outcomes provided on each slide deck. Remember, it was the second slide. Look at them and try to answer all those learning outcomes if you have really, understood them. If so, you have mastered this lecture. Congratulations. Second thing is participate in the exercises. Well, it gives you an understanding of the topic, the types of questions that will be asked in the exam, and how to solve issues. You get also feedback from the lecturer, particularly if you present some results and discuss the results, and of course from your peers as well. So it's also a good practice to schedule the time for the exercises in your weekly schedule somehow. So when you do it 3 hours a week, right, you could say, for example, Saturday, 10 to 1 o'clock, I schedule this 3 hour, right? And that's when I do my exercise. Or maybe I do 1 hour here and 2 hours there when I talk with my teammates, right? That would be great. And it's always a good idea to do some tasks, right? So in the exercise sheet, you will have multiple tasks. And even if you don't spend 3 hours, well, if you sometimes do just 1 hour, that is fine. You can do another week, some more hours if you want. But it's not a good idea to totally omit it because then, well, you don't get a big benefit of participating in the practicals, which really prepares you well for your exam. So a partial solution is better than no attempt, and using this extra hours to discuss issues is really important. Do quizzes if we provide them. Do further reading in topics that you are interested in. Team up again at some stage to prepare for the exam. Ask questions if you have any to colleagues and us. There is no bad question. And let me just end this by saying, we will support you as much as we can in your learning journey. But you are really the one that is responsible for the journey. Okay? And of course, you are responsible as well how you use us as a resource, as lecturers, where we are here to support you. Okay, in terms of communication, we use Blackboard, of course, with lectures, practicals, exercise sheets, and so on. We do some announcements, we have reading list, and we use Microsoft Teams a lot for the communications and the practicals and tutorials. We use it for any announcement as well. Feel free to use it to discuss issues, to solve exercises and so forth, and to find peers.